We have another scroller box. So let's pull it up. One little look and you're into your art supplies. I love that little thing that they have added there. So you can open it easier. And there we have in the inside of the box. We have a scroller in. We have some something good in. Let's just pick this thing out. That keep scrolling, put your box away. So let's see. Oh my, look at this. Oh, this is beautiful. The featured artist is Katarzyna Kmiecik. I probably butchered that and I'm so sorry, but this is what it says. Hopefully we can read it. Katarzyna Kmiecik is a professional artist and illustrator based in Poland, Poland. She's best known for her dream-like depictions of landscapes. Oh, this is beautiful. One day I will make one of this, and I love how the light shines through and highlights. Oh my god, this is gorgeous. I love this. So I guess that is something we can make landscapes thing of. Let's see. July 2020. Oh, aquarel. It was watercolor paper. Hey, now we're talking. Cold pressed. 300 gem and 140 lb, whatever. Cold press, 8 sheets. Textures. What is that? Control there. Anyways, the texture is quite smooth. Yeah, it feels like a good paper. So, like anything that contains a watercolor stuff. So let's open. There's some kind of paint. Scrawlrbox, palette-headed brush. We have a candy. Flat-headed brush. Sticker, artist print, water-soluble, that sketch. The sketch pencil. With two of them, it looks like. Double-ended eraser. The rough end of this eraser is the design of for ink, but it's but it does a good job removing any stubborn areas of this liquid graphite paints. What? Graphite paints. Sweet color combo. Try mixing the blue and yellow to make a green and expand your palette. Erasable paint. As these paints are graphite based, you can use the eraser to remove the graphite portion of the paint. Test this out. What? Really? And that brush is only available here. Supplies menu and 8 sheets of watercolor. So here is the artist for July. This is Katarzyna. So we have a little interview with her and we get to see some of her images. Oh my god, they are gorgeous. And we have some tips from her as well that we can read. And we have this Scrawlrbox gallery for what other people did this is for May. Beautiful. When we got all those charcoal bits. Yeah. My god, these are gorgeous. There are some amazing people out there. Capturing nature and keep a planting. Scrawlrbox keeps on planting. And now they are over 100,000 trees. That is amazing. So, So, graphite and erasable watercolors. I never heard of that. We have a sticker. Look at it. So we have yellow. G'day, 9. Liquid pencil re-abettable. My god, look what do I have? Liquid pencil. Oh my god, that stupid camera won't focus. Come on. There we have yellow and grey made in Australia. And it says liquid pencil re-abettable. And a blue. Yellow, blue and grey. My god. And the bad Russian, just taking that cap off, throwing that away. Put this brush in my little bottle container that I have here, so we can get off that setting that is on it. We have a candy. I'll leave that later on. And here we have this eraser. It's a natural rubber eraser from Koh-i-Noor. So it looks like this side is for regular pencils and this side is for pens and stuff, like ink. So let's get that away. And here we have these two. Dark wash and medium wash. 8B and 4B. Oh my god. The rubber... Oh my god, you can't even see it. The then sketching, and they are water soluble. That camera, dark wash, and medium wash. I hate my camera. Come on, seriously. Anyways, and they are water soluble. That is just amazing. Liquid pencil. So let's start. July. Darwin liquid pencil tubes re-abettable. Liquid pencil is an innovative graphite paint that allows you to create authentic graphite pencils effect and pencil sketches. Using a liquid medium, it can be thinned with water to allow for the softness of colors. And if you like a pencil, a liquid pencil, and want the best of the full range, we can get a discount. Then we go to soluble sketching pencil. This Durvent. I have Durvent sketching, but they're not the water soluble. So I guess that they come in both regular and water soluble. They have a soft white core that makes it perfect for creating loose bold lines when dry and when you add water, either with a brush or simply by dipping the pencil, the graphite will gently dissolve. Awesome. That is just amazing. That brush is a flat synthetic brush size 10. Koh-i-Noor combined eraser. This eraser comes with a two-part erasing ability. The soft and white is designed for the erasing medium to light graphite lines, and the firmer and the gray end is great for erasing darker graphite and ink. My god, I don't know if you can see it. And it's perfect for pairing up with the Darwin liquid pencil. I have no idea how to say that. And then we have the paper. Etival A5 CP, that is cold pressed butter color pad. Itchy sheet. Shall I like to get in light texture? Yeah. Mother Nature. Oh my god. Well, I can. We should just jump into this then. I can put that candy away. And that sticker and that eraser. I don't think that we will use that now, but we have to swatch out these colors and stuff. I mean, just swap that over. Oh my, these are... I can... I don't know how to maybe open it that way. Oh. Why do I need something more to open them? Maybe it says on the back. Liquid pencil allows artists to build in 6 syllable shades, relatable, Australian made. I guess I should get all 6 then. That's what you... But how in the world do you open this one? You see, it's all closed there, and this cap doesn't help anything at all. Well, I have tools. Come on. I thought I had tools. Oh. Oh my good god. Look at that. This one. That. And I should stir them well. Maybe it's enough if I shake it. Okay. We have some on my finger here. Oh my god, that looks like... I don't know. I have to put that in order as well. But, and this was supposed to be the yellow. Oh, I'll shake it. Maybe I'll shake these other ones as well. Gray 9 and that blue. Let's see. Just put out a little bit there. And this does not look like yellow low to me. Now we have the blue. I have a old rag, one of those inkdust rags there. Oh my god, and my camera is just going to totally wonky. Come on, yeah. Stay with me. Oh my god, why? Ah, oh, this is so hard to open. That. So then we have some blue here. There. Let me shake up this gray. So let's put a little bit on there. I am scared that I might be dirty after all of this, but I'll just clean up that tool and let's see if this brush is okay. It is. So let us just see what we get here. This does not really look like yellow low to me. It looks more like baby poop, actually. So this is... That was the gray. Yeah, I can see the difference in color. Then we have the blue down here. Yeah. So, we are making some modern nature. Let's bring you guys in. We can make, maybe I should tear this off. Just use this as a palette on the side here. Oh my good god, and that camera. It needs something to focus on. Just putting that there. So we have the dark wash and the medium wash. for me. Yeah, well, so I can sketch up out some mountains, I guess. One there, and go one up here. So, like that. That was really the dark marsh, so maybe I should just put some dark down here first. I have no idea how to actually use these things together. But let's see. Then we have the medium, so I guess that I should put that a little bit further up. I have no idea how these solvable they are either. But I want to start with the sky, so let me just turn this around. Getting all of this paper. That. So this is, it's not really wet wet, but it is quite damp. So, but how in the world this will be yellow, I have no idea of, because this really doesn't look like yellow to me. And again, and shake, oops, that was way too much. Well, let's see. We can water this down. So we make a sky out of this supposed to be yellow. No, it doesn't really float like watercolors. But I guess that that is okay, because this isn't watercolors. This is graphite, actually. It's just, this is amazing. So let's leave some clouds up there and have a little bit darker on the top. I like to kind of have a, like a frame the top of the sky. Let's see if we can pull that further down and make a smoother transition. No, we could not. Not really. Okay, if I'm working it, it looks like the So, here we have the sky. Can I lift up a little sun or a moon or something? See if I can make something look like that there. Here. Like that. I guess I should turn off that autofocus, because it kind of drives me nuts. That we have this blue, put that for the, maybe I actually should start with the mountains. Just dissolve this lighter gray. And here. Let's see if we can remove some of that hard edge. Oh, we can! Yay! So the pencil dissolved actually quite well. Pick up some of that gray and put in a little bit more that. But since this mountain is further back, it should be lighter than the other one, because the closer the thing is to you, the more clear the colors and darker the colors will be. So for this mountain, leave it quite pale. Not fancy that hard line that we have there, so I should try to solve that in. Try to weave at it first then. Not really want to, don't want to just push it further up, want to dissolve it so it kind of vanish, something like that maybe. Okay, so that's that, but we need this one to be darker. We can actually have it quite a lot darker as well, putting in some rocks. We need more water because this got dry. So it's gonna dry it up. A flat brush is not what I'm usually working with, and I'm not really that low with how to use that, but let's try to take out some highlights. Using that again as a palette. So I've seen artists who can paint like anything with a palette, but a brush. I'm definitely not there. So let's wet all of this and see if we can make this into some kind of water. Just wetting that first. Should try to pile up. And I'm leaving some white lines in this. So and again trying to darken it up further or the closer we get to us. I didn't tape this down, maybe I should have done that. Don't really think that this is blue. I don't know. That might just be me. Let's put in some waves. Some smaller ones up there. This is a medium I think that I can learn to enjoy, actually. So this was actually quite fun. Then again, anything with water, I'm happy with. Some of that, because I think the blue actually was quite darker than that gray, maybe. Let's get that edge there, that line. Now, I don't like that stripe that I have over there with that moon or sun or whatever it is. Let's see, I have to lift this. Get some of that, what they call yellow. Put some yellow in the mountain. Giving that a little bit more earthy. And I'm so sorry for not speaking, but don't really like how my moon came up. Now, can I fix things with this medium? Let me see if I can put some on here and paint over all of this. Oops. Put on that water. Okay. Maybe it's easier to. No, I have a spray bottle. But I don't have it here. Of course I don't. Yeah, well, anyways, let's see if we can pull this down. Putting on a lot of water there. Like that, making it really nice and wet, so we can hopefully we can make that wash a little bit more even again. Like that. And going working all the way to the bottom, or actually to the top. Oh my god, you can see how wet it is. It is insane. But I think I need something to, I need a trick to get around some. So I'm just taking this one of the pencils using the backside. I'm wrapping my old rag around the tip. And I'm just lifting out some of that color that we have right there. Maybe I will want some
sunrise again. Make some of those like that as well. Just making them lost my sun again. Come on. That was very dark right there. Okay. So we did not get anything white with this box. So I think that I should cheat. I have some white gouache. So just putting in a little brown. Just a little bit. I guess that this effect would be better if I had an even darker sky, but oops, oh my god, no, oh, look at this. Wonder if I mix it with that gouache, what will happen then? Anyway, this is fun, guys. I can sit here and fiddle with that for hours. But not like that hard line, so I have to try to erase some of that. Oops, you can't even see what I'm doing. Erasing some of that. Get some of that yellow on the chair so we got some variations in colors, making it a little bit more I'd like. Yeah. I have no idea what is going on back there. Maybe we have a cave. Let's see if I get some more of that gray here. No, I did not. Come on, can I reveal it? That's my palette over here. I have a little bit. Come on. Yes. So, you can. So let us put in probably be a little cave, and then we need some rocks, some happy little rocks. Isn't that what Bob Ross would have said? Stabbing in some small I think that mountain back there just kind of disappeared in the background, so I'm not quite sure, but maybe we should try to darken that up a little bit. If we do mix this blue and that, what they call yellow, I have to turn it again. I'm so sorry. That. There, I brought it back. So
I do love that kind of a color that I'm getting on my what I'm using as a palette there. I think I should darken up that. Where's that blue? Let's see a little bit more as well. But this is so weird. I'm actually painting with graphite. Who would have thought that? That is what even an option. I need more water. And I probably should stop fiddling with this. At the same time, I really want to test this out. Like a good go. Putting back in some waves. Come on, there as well. Tiny ones, come on. Like that. Oh my god, this is fun. I should have put in a reflection on that stuff, but and that sky should actually be darker, but to be calling that yellow, I don't know. Anyways, this is what I managed to do with the supplies. I used everything except from the eraser. So I should zoom out a little bit more like that. Yeah. Is this drying up so I can write on it? I guess so. Let me see. Medium. It's called dark wash and medium wash. Oh, that did not show up at all. But anyways, yeah, that was it from the July Scrawlrbox. This was exciting. Liquid pencil re-vettable from Derby Bayon. It said that it comes in 6 shades, so they remind me a little bit about the Garefitint pencils from the advent. So I can actually use them together with them. I think that would be perfect. So as always, I will link, I will find this artist, Katarzyna Kmiecik. She has the page, Facebook, Insta, Twitter, and Behance. I have no idea what that is, never heard of it. But I will post the links that I can find underneath this video. And let me put that over there, so let's see if we can get everything in place. And I will eat my candy later on. I don't know where to put this. I'll probably put my hand in it later on. So anyway, this was the Scrawlrbox for July. So
Thank you everybody so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Until then, stay safe, and I will see you all later. Bye!